The Heenan family is on a roll. Last week, the biggest team in professional wrestling. Nobody could beat them. They thought they were indispensable, indestructible. The Can-Am connection. Well, now that I'm managing the Islanders, Haku and Toma, you saw what happened. The Can-Am were defeated, just like everybody else is going to be defeated, because Bobby the Brain Heenan is on a roll. The Heenan family is on a roll. Now that I got Haku and Toma, the Islanders, bring on the tag team champions of the world. We are ready for them and anybody else. I've done it again.
Ladies and gentlemen, due to the overwhelming public response and the view of the board of directors of the World Wrestling Federation, the DDT will not be banned.
And now, Jake the Snake Roberts.
No doubt that if you're going to be able to see the invisible, you have to do that before you can do the impossible. And the World Wrestling Federation gets its athletes from all over the world. And they don't come here because it's a lot of fun being in that ring. They come here because it's big money. They come here because they want to be the best. To be the best, you have to beat the best. So whether they come from Canada, Mexico, England, or even Australia, as my next guest, Outback Jack.
Hi. Good night. How are you? Good night, mate.
Do you have any of these things in Australia?
Yeah, mate, we do. We tend to keep them to ourselves, you know. We don't go near them too much.
I notice you have a little friend on your back.
Oh, that's me mate Irving, mate. Yeah, Irving me croc.
Irving?
Yeah, mate. Yeah, I was fishing one day for a big barra, see, and Irving come up, bit the tail off the barra, and he died with a fishbone, so I thought I'd cut his head off and stick him on me back.
Well, I think that's one way of handling something. Let me ask you something, Outback. What do you think of the competition here?
Oh, mate, it's the absolute best. It's the best. There's nothing like it anywhere in the universe, mate. It's just fantastic.
Well, being away from home, do you miss Australia?
Oh, of course you miss Australia, mate, but this is my second home, mate, because the place is full of such wonderful people.
Not all of us are wonderful people.
Oh, well, mate, you know, you can't really dispute that.
I mean, what do you say about people like Bobby Heenan, Paul Orndorff?
Well, mate, you know, they've done nothing to me, so I don't have an opinion about them one way or the other.
Well, when you step into the ring, what do you have to do?
Mate, you got to win, you know, that's the game and name of the game. You're in there to win.
So you see, folks, it doesn't matter where you're from. The bottom line is this. You have got to step up, take that shot. And when you take that shot, you got to make it count. Because if you'd have missed Irving, Irving might have not have missed you.
Well, mate, there's no doubt Irving would have bit me hand off. There's no doubt about that. You know, he's a hungry bugger.
Well, folks, from Australia, Outback Jack, it's a pleasure, man. I'm glad you come out to say hello to these fine people. We're going to be back.
I told everyone that I would be the fighting champion. It didn't matter who came up first. Savage, it didn't matter. Honky Tonk, it just happened to be you, and I'll take you on here next week.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, we will hear from the Honky Tonk Man, who is determined to wear the gold around his waist. Here now, the man from Memphis, Tennessee.
I can't wait, Jimmy, next week. You know, I got all these sequins on my suit. I got this belt right here, but it's just not big enough. Next week, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat, the Honky Tonk Man, is going to have the Intercontinental belt around his waist. That's just what I need. I need more gold. I need something just a little bit bigger for the Honky Tonk Man, and I can play loud and clear.
There's actually people out there that think that the Hart Foundation is hiding behind the World Heavyweight Tag Team Championship belt.
We're not hiding behind these belts. The Hart Foundation, we don't hide. We'll take on anybody, anywhere, anytime, any city, any time zone.
Any place. Because the Hart Foundation, we fear nobody. We fear no evil, right, Anvil?
That's right, it, man. We are not afraid.
We are not afraid.
I'm glad that you use the word devastating, because that's exactly to the T that fits the big 747 right here. This man is so mean and so ferocious that he got up this morning and slapped himself a couple of times. He's so mean, I'm even scared of him. You understand what I'm talking about, Daddy?
What about this move that you got to, what is that name?
Well, you know, you can thank me for that. I'm responsible for it.
Tell us about it.
I told him to utilize his size, baby, and he climbed to that second turnbuckle and grabs a man by the back of his head and passes him down to the floor. You call it the Master Blaster.
Well, you know, let me tell you something. There's going to be a lot of hospital bills due because my hobby is beating people up. When I get up in the morning, that's all I have on this brain is to beat somebody up. So whoever gets in the ring with me, you better be ready for the beating of your...
And now, Jake the Snake Robert.
You know, sometimes you pick up the paper, you see something, you don't like it. Sometimes you're right there live in person, you don't like what you see. Sometimes you just hear about it. Well, one time at WrestleMania 3, there was something that made me pretty sick. And to show you what happened, I'm going to invite the two people that were involved, because there was a little man and there was a big man involved, too. Let's talk about contrast of people. Hillbilly Jim, your tag team partner, Little Big Rob. I tell you the truth, Hillbilly. I'll keep the snake away from you, all right? I'll tell you the truth. I don't see you're a lucky man to be alive. He's a very lucky man.
Well, Jake, he is lucky. And I'll say this, that was the lowest thing I've ever seen. I'll tell you, WrestleMania 3, King Kong Bundy did the lowest doggone thing anybody could ever do. He tried to hurt this little fella, and he wanted not only permanent injury, but I think he wanted to put him out of professional wrestling out of life.
Now, what kind of man does that make you when you stand 6'2", weigh 450 pounds, and you jump on somebody like that, huh?
Makes you a coward, Jake. That's exactly what you are, King Kong Bundy, a big coward. And I can't wait, Jake, to get my chance. I can't wait to get my chance just to get a hold of you, King Kong, buddy, and show you that you ain't the man you thought you are. And I'll tell you this, you're a big coward, because anybody that would try to hurt a little fella like this, they ain't got no guts at all.
Little Beaver, do you have something you'd like to tell the people, my man?
Yes. I can say that I was hurt, I was in hospital, and I'm here to give this man here, Hillbilly Jim, advice, and that big fat, whatever you want to call him, you'll get it.
Well, the way I see it, it's all up to you, my man, because I tell you something, it doesn't matter what size you are. When you weigh 450 pounds and you splash somebody, you got to hurt.
It takes a big horse to pull a big load. I'm one big horse, King Kong Bundy.
That's right.
Is for the Intercontinental Heavyweight Championship.
I hope he plays the guitar behind his back. I like it when he does that. Oh, he's not doing it.
And an undeserved title opportunity in my book.
Why?
I don't think he's deserving. His opponent is from Hawaii. The Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion, Ricky the Dragon.
When he won the title, he was going to be a fighting champion, and he has done just that. He has taken on all comers.
Over the top rope. No, look at this maneuver. Oh, look at that.
Into the ring. Out comes the Honky Tonk Man, and the Dragon is breathing fire.
The Dragon's hot, but the match is far from over. Far from over. A beautiful back suplex.
The Dragon firing off the bullet shot. Honky Tonk Man may be sorry he signed on for the title match.
Yes, indeed, the Dragon, Ricky Steamboat, really taking care of business this week.
You know, I think Honky deserves the shot over his big win over Jake the Snake in WrestleMania. I think that's what got it for him.
Big win, you call that, huh?
What did you call it? He won. And it certainly was big.
Well, maybe not win the record, but shot to the pectoral area.
Come on, Honky Tonk, you gotta get help, baby. Not again. Come on, baby. Come on, baby. Come on, Honky.
Sings on the Dragon off the rope. Honky Tonk misses with a roundhouse slap. Behind him now. The Dragon drops the Honky Tonk to buckle. Closing up. We get to it.
Whoa. Did you see that? Honky Tonk fired him. He went head first into that buckle.
Very lucky maneuver on the part of the Honky Tonk match. Dallas momentum shifting back in the favor of the Honky Tonk match. Dragon with his throat snapped off the top rope.
And look at Honky, went to school on him. He knows the Dragon has that injured larynx. And he's going after it.
Thanks to Savage, yes. Honky Tonk. Moving in now on the Dragon. And the Dragon fighting right back. Another shot by the Dragon, Ricky Steamboat. Honky Tonk man. Hanging right in there, however. You can hear, of course, Jimmy Hart with that megaphone in the background.
That's got to be a lot of help to a wrestler in there, you know, knowing that Jimmy's behind him.
And now, once again, the tide is turned. Steamer, what a kick that was to the ribs. Another one to the chest. Ricky Steamboat hammering away, chopping away on a Honky Tonk man. Gets him out, snaps him over now. The Dragon measuring a Honky Tonk man. Maybe even at this moment sensing victory.
Oh, he's close. I'm not gonna doubt it.
Honky Tonk man off the run.
But as they say,
left baseline. Honky Tonk man moving it.
Whoa.
First maneuver by the Dragon.
That was a saving maneuver by the Dragon. He was ready to
shoot. Honky Tonk man missed. Honky Tonk was coming right ahead of steam. Ooh, now like a steamroller. But now it may be stopped. Downstairs goes the Dragon. Upstairs now. I don't think the Dragon has ever looked so good. Out to the apron.
He's going up.
The Dragon now. Oh, what's Jimmy Hart doing? Get him down from there. What a shot. Cover. Hart, turn around.
He's tied up.
Turn around. Turn around.
I'm not sure.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of this contest.
I can't believe it.
Honky Tonk won. Unbelievable. And you said he wasn't a contender. He's the new Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion.
And I can't believe that.
And you said he wasn't even a contender. He's the champion. A major, major upset.
I can't believe it.
What an upset. He's got the tag team champion. He's got the Intercontinental champion.
We'll be back. I'm in a state of shock. We'll be back. Let's go back now, ladies and gentlemen, to the match we just saw. And this crowd is stunned. They can't believe we have a new Intercontinental champion.
But, you know, I want to see this spin all over again because it's kind of confusing to me. Now, here we see the Dragon with a terrific drop kick. But now watch here. It gives almost like, you might call it a DDT here, a small package, whatever he's trying to do. But look at the, there he is. Yes, he was pinned. There's no question about it. The Honky Tonk Man's shoulders were up.
That's right.
What about next week, Carver, right now coming back into the ring. I can't believe it. The new Intercontinental Champion, the Honky Tonk Man. The Honky Tonk Man, the new Intercontinental Champion. Next week to join us, we'll be joined.
All right, with the Can-Am Connection, and guys, I know you were both shocked and upset after what happened. After all, it was supposed to be a scientific match, But then Bobby Heenan and the Islanders changed all that very quickly.
That's right, Craig. You know, we're still shocked because, you know, we're actually looking forward to this match against the Islanders. But no, they had it planned all along, you know, with that Bobby Heenan. They attacked us from behind. But the Islanders, we're going to get even with you. Believe me.
Tom?
Just like Rick said, they jumped us from behind. What a surprise. They're a couple of great wrestlers, and you wouldn't think they'd have to resort to a man like Heenan in their
They call Ron Bass the Outlaw for good reason, because as you know, the Outlaw has been known to bend and break rules over time, and
What is the business? When you talk about somebody bending and breaking rules, that means they do something behind somebody's back. And I never do anything behind anybody's back. I'll look you eyeball to eyeball and look you toe to toe, baby. Let me tell you something, what I'm coming out here for now is to introduce a friend of mine. We're going to call her old Betsy. Huh? And let me tell you something, people. There's a lot of people like Hulk Hogan, Tito Santana, Ricky Steamboat. There's a bunch of people out there. You're going to be feeling the pain. You're going to be feeling the sting of old Betsy before I'm done. Because when the Outlaw, he first got to the... He says, hey, you're going to take notice, and I guarantee you, I've got the thing right here to make you turn around and look at the Big Outlaw, because the Big Outlaw is a man to be feared, and right here is something that's backing me up. So people, whenever the Outlaw's on the card, you better believe I'm going to be there live and in color, and old Betsy right by my side. I'll be looking for you.
Introducing in the ring at a total combined weight of 798 pounds, first... From Hamilton, Ontario, Canada, Iron Mike Sharp. From Kansas City, Ace Cowboy Bob Orton. And from Sunset Beach, Hawaii, the Magnificent Morocco.
I called it. I knew it was going to happen.
You didn't say anything about it.
I did, too. I did, too.
Boy, I was looking to jump on somebody else's bandwagon.
But the man won it, and I told you he was going to... Oh, I don't want to talk to you.
Just another reason for you to be more jealous now of the Colonel.
I'm not jealous of him. Will you quit saying that?
Six-man tag team action. The Magnificent One, Don Morocco, along with Ace, former henchman, Cowboy Bob Orton. And Iron Mike Sharp.
Now he's got two titles. That's fine.
I thought you said you weren't jealous.
I'm not jealous. I dropped that subject. I'm singing the praises.
Oh, okay. Yeah, he's got the World Tag Team Champions and the Intercontinental Champion.
I know that.
Boy, what a claim to fame that is. Who you got? What, you got any titles? No, not a one.
You don't need to hear. You answer a question and you answer it yourself.
Well, I want to get the right answer. With a nice hip lock on Billy Jack. The powerhouse out of Portland, Oregon. Sitting there with a real ring technician and mechanic. Not too many guys can do what the Cowboy can do. Cat, got your tongue? Or should I say, has the mouth of the South got your tongue? Side headlock by Ace. He won't stay in this long. Got rid of him in a hurry. Nice shoulder block. Down in front quickly. Leapfrog of beauty. And a hip lock of his own. I tell you what, not only is Billy Jack a powerhouse, he's got speed as well. He's taking on the whole team.
Show off.
Guaranteed, he's still got a lot of scores to settle with one Hercules.
He better go back to Oregon and play in the trees.
That war is not over by a long shot, I don't think, Brent.
No, it's not.
How are you going to keep the mouth shut now of the Honky Tonk Man? Now that he's got the gold around his waist.
He earned it. I told you he was going to win it. I predicted it.
At least you're saying that. Not many believe in it.
I'll tell you, I even gave Jimmy a little insight. I helped him.
You helped him. You can't even help yourself. How are you going to help somebody else? SD in there along with Hillbilly. Calling in the third man as Iron Mike comes in. He got trapped in the corner. Oh, it's a big chain hookup now.
The ring's moving.
Whole ring shifted about 4 or 5 inches. And Morocco was at the bottom of all that.
The referee has lost control here.
Rams him into the head of Special Delivery Jones. And SD, the southpaw out of Antigua, going to work.
Smallest guy in there, 250 pounds.
Big headbutt by SD. Look out. Oh, scoop slam. Morocco looking for his corner, a little bit dazed there, makes the tag to Iron Mike. Nobody home as he telegraphed that one.
Wait a minute. Orton and Morocco are arguing.
Well, sometimes they have a difference of opinion. Oh, look at that. Morocco nailed his own man. And SD gets the cover. And look at Orton get on Morocco's case. Taking money right out of his pocket.
Boy, are they frustrated.
The winners of this bout, the team of Hillbilly Jim, SD Jones, and Billy Jack.
Is a non-title match scheduled for one fall. Introducing to my left, at a total combined weight of 473 pounds, B. Brian Blair, Jumping Jim Brunzel, the Killer Bee. Their opponents are managed by the Mouth of the South, Jimmy Hart. Danny Davis.
What's he doing in there? He's part of the Hart Foundation.
World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champion. At a total combined weight of 515 pounds, Jim the Anvil Neidhart, Brett Pittman Hart, the Hart Foundation.
The Hart Foundation. Still don't know what Danny Davis is doing there.
Danny Davis is part of the Hart Foundation, probably there to keep an eye on refereeing. He knows a lot about that.
Yeah, he just gave a bit of business there to referee Dave Hebner a moment ago.
This is going to be a great, great matchup.
There he is. Davis on the outside a moment ago, causing static already with Brunzel.
He's not doing nothing.
He's there for one reason only. That's because he scratched the beast and tried to do everything he can to put him at a disadvantage. That's what he's doing, Jesse.
Hart Foundation pulling out all the stops.
And the Harts are sending their power man in early, the Anvil. Come on,
Anvil. Brunzel now lifts it up. Anvil missing. Comes in. I'll beg your pardon. That's Blair in there.
Blair on the scoop. Nice maneuver. We're going to get one, two in there.
Almost three.
Whoa, we almost had a big upset there.
Brunzel, difficult to tell them apart, especially when they put on the mask.
Well, you can't tell them apart without the mask. What difference does it make?
Similar body styles. Both great wrestlers. Come on, Davis. Referee, look at this, right away. Davis is objecting to the way Hebner is officiating the match.
Well, obviously, Davis has seen something about Hebner's officiating he don't like. Davis has a lot of experience in refereeing.
Well, he'll never referee again. Davis having distinction being the only official ever to be barred. What? Lifetime barred.
Tunney barred him. Somebody may impeach Tunney before it's all over. He's not in there for life, you know.
On one side of the ring and Jimmy Hart on the other.
Probably so that they can give instructions from both ends of the ring depending on where the match is taking place. Smart moves on the part of Jimmy Hart.
That's Bologna, you know it, Jesse. They're trying to distract because they know that they got two guys in that ring that could very easily upset them. And they don't want that because if they do, then they'll have to give them a title shot.
Well, it's no different, Bruno, than you up here trying to distract me at the mic.
I beg your pardon. There's a big difference there. Jim Brunzel, trying to make his way over the tag.
But you see how smart the Harts are. They keep Brunzel in their corner. That's good tag team wrestling. You can make the tags, your opponents can't.
Brunzel. In these rounds, we may get three, two, and no, sir.
Now, I'm going to call it like it is. That was a surprisingly sloppy cover by Bret the Hitman right there. He should have hooked that leg and gone for a more serious pin.
Brunzel trying to fire out of there. But no. The Hitman cuts him off. What's going on here? The Hitman with Brunzel. Nice block by Brunzel. Retaliation right here to the throat. Another chop to the throat. Brunzel hammering away. Oh, wait a minute. You saw that blatantly.
What happened there? Hey, look at what's Blair doing out there.
Davis.
Look at Bret Hart's got him pinned right in the middle of the ring. Where's that referee? Where's the incompetent referee?
Oh, wait a minute. Yes. Davis is going to be escorted back, I think.
What?
Davis is going to be escorted back. Dave Hepburn, the referee, is saying get out of here.
Mark Conn.
Danny Davis can get them for possible police brutality right there.
Meanwhile, the killer bees have found the mask.
Wait a minute.
Is that Brunzel or Blair?
No, that's Blair in the ring. They did not tag. That's illegal. That is illegal.
I'm not so sure.
You're not sure. I'm sure.
Whoever it is, he's cleaning house in there. Drop the elbow.
That is not the legal bee in the ring.
Brunzel or Blair, remember, maybe Sunset Flip. Can't get him over. Hanging on for dear life. Neidhart comes in. Move that man back.
What is this?
Look at that.
Oh, now what is this?
1, 2, 3.
Oh, I can't believe this.
An incredible victory.
Now, I suppose you guys are happy with that. You guys think that was a fair decision?
Listen to this capacity crowd.
Answer my questions.
An unbelievable victory.
The killer bee.
Answer my question. Do you think that was a fair decision?
There's no question. The killer bees remain victorious.
No way. You answer my question. That was taken all the way.
He's victorious
now. Jake. The Snake Roberts.
Freak out, freak out. Oh, yeah. Congratulations to the Honky Tonk Man, the new Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion. How do you like that, Snake Roberts?
You're happy that the Honky Tonk Man beat Ricky Steamboat?
Oh, yeah, the new champion right
hold
there.
Hold, you want you back up for a second, man. Why don't you just hold on? I've seen you trying to save Steamboat from losing that title once before. He could have ripped it right then, but you didn't. Now you're saying you're glad the Honky Tonk Man won?
Oh, no, Mr. Snake Roberts. The Macho Man and Macho Madness has got everything in proper perspective, yeah. Oh, yeah. I'm going to the top of the mountain now, and I'm going to take my place in all-time history. Hulk Hogan, the Macho Man, Randy Savage, just pointing at you, man. I'm going to be the new World Heavyweight Champion.
You know what they say, man? They say that the worst curse in life is to have unlimited potential. And I think you're safe. I don't think you have any type of curse to worry about.
You're on a wane right now. Macho Madness will surpass Hulkamania. And I'm not promising that. I'm guaranteeing that I will take the title.
You didn't take Steamboat, and now you think you're going to take the biggest man out here?
Macho Madness over Hulkamania. And you, Hulk Hogan, I've got your number. And your number is 2. And the Macho Man Randy Savage's number is 1. And all you got to be stupid not to figure that out. Macho Madness will surpass Hulkamania. And I guarantee the Macho Man Randy Savage will win the World Heavyweight Championship belt.
I tell you, brother, you believe in yourself, and that's important in life, to believe in yourself. But I tell you something, my man, just between you and I don't think you're going to get it done. You know what I mean?
Ain't no way possible that I will not take the title. Elizabeth, get out of there, man. We're history.
Good luck, because I think he's going to need it.
Yeah, that's right. You got the superstar right here. Now, you know, the doctor says, superstar, you'll never be in a gym again. You might look at one from the outside, but you'll never be in a gym and never lift a weight as long as you live. But I'm here to tell the doctors, I'm here to tell the skeptics, the superstars in the gym. It's a little lightweight, but it's a start, and superstar's going to start.
After Graham's recent hip operation, noted orthopedic surgeon Dr. Lawrence Doerr told the superstar he'd be fortunate to walk healthy again. As far as wrestling, the doctor told the superstar to draft that retirement speech. But the superstar always did his best talking in the ring. And that championship spirit is winning out. So against doctor's orders, he's back in the gym.
Wow. Oh. Oh.
Ah. Superstar, stop. It isn't worth it.
Oh, it's okay. I can do it. I can do it, Aaron. Oof. 2 more.
Oh. Even to this day, though, despite his efforts, naturally, most are saying that the superstar will never return. After all, with the magnitude of his hip injury and the nature of wrestling, a metal hit would be just too vulnerable.
Tag team match. 8 scheduled for Holden Fall. Introducing in the ring at a total combined weight of 908 pounds.
I've never heard
of such a thing. The team of Mario Mancini, Don Driggers, Jim Powers, and Paul Roma. Their opponent, coming down the aisle, managed by Bobby the Brain Heenan, introducing Hercules and King Harley.
With the King, Harley Race, and behind the King, Hercules Hernandez.
I'm a little confused here. I mean, there's 4 opponents in the ring, and there's only Heenan, Hercules, and Race. And Heenan's not wrestling. Is this 4 against 2 or what?
That'd be some handicap match. But I'm sure Heenan doesn't have the guts to put anything like that in the ring. He would never go for a handicap tag team.
Well, I'll tell you, if they can score a win 4 against 2, I'll be impressed.
I think Heenan grabbed the mic.
Oh, you lucky people, are you in for a treat? And the whole world of sports, I want you to get a load of this. The 3rd member of our team from Atlantic City, New Jersey, has 438 pounds. That's
oh,
right.
Oh, look at that.
No more than this, because Bundy's equal to 2, no doubt about it.
I'll grant you that.
They don't need no more than this. They got the condominium.
Look how big Bundy is. He's huge. Man is man.
Full strength, because the 4th man in this team, at 252 pounds, from Tampa, Florida.
Wow.
individuals could stop this awesome Heenan family combination. The King, Hercules, Bundy, and now Mr. Wonderful.
I'll tell you. And Bobby Heenan, what a destruction crew in that ring. Look at that.
My goodness. Heenan proud of himself, as perhaps well he should be for assembling this caliber of talent all in the ring under his wing.
That's right.
Bobby the Brain Heenan, as a matter of fact, earlier on had this comment about the Heenan family.
Well, are you surprised? I'm not surprised, but I hope you're surprised, because you're looking at the Bobby Heenan family, the most devastating force in professional wrestling today. The warning's going out to everyone.
Mr. Wonderful, Paul Arndorf, quicker than ever. I think even a bit more aggressive than we saw him last.
Oh, I'm liking it. I mean, Wonderful's looking truly wonderful. Here comes the big man.
On the 25th of July, it's a Saturday night special in Madison Square Garden, where you will see Russian Nikolai Volkoff meet Tito Santana. Also on the card, Greg the Hammer Valentine opposes Brutus the Barber Beefcake. And from there, the Intercontinental Champion, yes, it's the Honky Tonk Man, defends the belt against Jake the Snake Roberts, Saturday night, July 25th in Madison Square Garden.
Gregor swept the rope and off. Oh, my goodness, what a clothesline.
A cover. And look at Hercules picks him up. Whoa. What kind of statement is Bobby Heenan trying to make here?
Can you believe this? The King, Harley Race now, tagged in. The fourth member of the Heenan family. Gregor's on the shoulder. Goes for a ride. Power slam to the canvas.
Picks him up. They could have had three pinfalls right now.
What's going to happen next? Heenan's going to be tagged in. Give me a break. This poor man, Driggers, has had no opportunity to tag out.
Driggers needs overtime, I think, for this one.
Arndorf in total control.
Look at the viciousness of Wonderful. I love it. Ooh, with a kick. That's what makes Mr. Wonderful so dangerous in that ring. You think you got him for a minute, but he can reverse it faster than anybody.
Arndorf!
Wow, right to the side of the face.
Tagging on a Harley Race. Powers being set up off clothesline. What a technician Harley Race is.
That's right, he's the technician of the team. You got the fighting spirit in Orndorff. You got the size and power of Bundy and the sheer strength of Hercules. I can't believe it.
I guess you're proud of Heenan for assembling this kind of talent.
Wouldn't you be? Wouldn't you be impressed?
I'm impressed. Tag is made now. Mancini tagged in. Hercules hammering away on Mancini. Hercules with Mancini. Oh, my goodness.
Every one of these guys can wrestle, I'll tell you.
No, I don't hear them yelling, not at all.
You got a headset on. You can count to 20 on that. Look at Heenan, he loves it.
Look, what an arrogant count.
Ah, beautiful.
The winners of this contest, the Bobby Heenan family.
Let's go back to the replay.
This was
saw some. Look at this. Now here comes the power drop by Mr. Wonderful. And boom. And there goes Mancini. This was, you know, really a mismatch in all fairness. These two forces are too much of a force for those individuals.
All right, let's catch up now, ladies and gentlemen, with another superstar here in the World Wrestling Federation.
Paul Roma. The opponent, soon to be entering the ring area, is accompanied by his manager, Colonel Jimmy Hart, from Memphis, Tennessee, weighing 255 pounds, the new Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion, the Honky Tonk Man.
Boy, if he had a smile on his face before, he's surely got one now. And the mouth, the Colonel is so proud. Look at the gold around the waist of the Honky Tonk Man.
You know, I helped the Colonel. I gave him a little few little tidbits and insights. We collaborated a little bit on that victory he had over Steamboat.
Please, you expect me to buy that?
What, are you calling me a liar again?
You called him a pipsqueak last week.
Well, you said he called me a...
He called you a weasel.
You're trying to start trouble. I'm not going to let this happen. He's too good a friend of mine.
Oh, yeah, I'll bet. Mark that one down. Talk about a guy being cocky. Talk about a guy being stuck on himself. He was that way 100% without any gold around his waist. He'll be unlivable now.
Better get used to it. He's going to have it a long, long time.
Honky Tonk Man going to work immediately on the left arm and shoulder as the Colonel with the guitar looks on. Switched around there for a moment. Look out. Atomic drop for Hess. Yes. He nailed him with it. Beautiful drop kick. Honky obviously didn't do his homework. Thought he had a piece of cake here in this youngster. Out of the way of the elbow drop.
See, Roma makes a big mistake when he gets in that ring. He tries to use his brains.
Well, last week we took a look. We saw the first man to congratulate the Honky Tonk Man was, in fact, the Macho Man.
From the dragon, giving the opportunity. But the Honky Tonk Man, congratulations, because the Macho Man and Macho Madness going to the top of the mountain to get you, Hulk Hogan. Yeah.
Well, Savage, obviously not all that upset about not getting the victory back, that he dropped the strap to the dragon. He's looking for higher things, bigger things, better things, mainly the World's Heavyweight Championship held by Hulk Hogan.
And he's got as good a chance as anybody to win it, maybe even better.
Well, a lot of you guys had a chance to win it, couldn't do it.
That's because everybody was against me with that lousy officiating I had to stand for.
You really got a persecution complex. You think, look at this.
Ho, ho, ho.
It's the shake, rattle, and roll coming up. He nailed him with it.
Better than ever. One.
Goodbye. Look
two,
at him. He didn't even mess his hair
three
up in this match. Honky Tonk Man. Easy victory here this week on Wrestling Challenge.
The winner of this bout, the new Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion, the Honky Tonk Man.
Oh, he's got a right to be proud, Monsoon.
You'd be proud.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. I did it all for you.
Oh,
this is
on
your belt. Thank you very much. You're a beautiful audience. I love you.
What a humble
now
man.
Turn the music on. You want to see the Honky Tonk Man dance? Turn that music on, Bobby.
Do we have to? Talk about lack of talent, not wrestling talent for sure, but dancing talent and playing and singing.
Gorilla, if you keep your mouth shut, you learn something here. You learn some steps.
What? You're not singing.
I mean you learn some steps, some rhythm.
Please. Let's go back and take a look at the famed and shape, rattle, and roll. Nobody does it any better than this.
Look at the snap here. Watch this. There.
Roll them right into the middle next week. Right now, let's go to Greg DeGeorge with the British Bulldogs and, of course, Matilda.
With the British Bulldogs, Davey Boy Smith, the Dynamite Kid, and guys, I want to ask you about Matilda. It seems as though she gives you a bit of good luck.
That's right, Greg. We're going in the dressing room.
Yeah.
She gives us advice on how to beat our opponents.
She gives you advice.
She gives us advice, Greg. She gives us advice on how to beat our opponents. and she takes care of the managers in the World Wrestling Federation.
This next bout is scheduled for one fall. Introducing in the ring from Platte Lake, Minnesota, weighing 260 pounds, Rick Renslow. The opponent, making his way to the ring area, hails from Portland, Oregon, weighing 267 pounds, the former Olympian, Ken Patera.
Listen to the ovation here by this capacity crowd as they're standing for the former Olympian, Ken Patera.
How can these people
touch? Oh, look at that. Look at the neck brace.
What is this? What is this?
Oh, we got a number of them. Patera loves it. Hey, go look. He's pointing right at you, Brain. He's pointing right at... He's right here, Kenny. I got my eye on him. He's right here. Where are you going? Sit down here. You're in a broadcast position. You want to be in worse trouble than you're in right now?
I want somebody to make sure that man does not leave the ring and make a move up here towards me. The man's an animal. He's a violent human being. He's a violent animal. He shouldn't be in professional wrestling. He's not responsible for what he does. And I'm not going to pay the price because he wasn't kept in the can where he belongs.
You already paid.
Yes,
shut up, right. Your big mouth, and you had to pay for it. Can't believe that you actually physically attacked Kenny Patera.
Well, it just shows you how this man, the effect he has on people, the way he treats people, and what he stands for.
You're supposed to be the Brain. You lost your cool, Brain. Rick Renslow about to feel the wrath of Kenny Patera, possibly the strongest man in the world today.
No, he isn't.
Well, who is?
Hercules, oh, Andre the Giant, any member of my family.
Do they have any kind of credentials that could match up to those of Kenny Patera?
No, you're right, Monsoon. None of them did time.
I'm talking about credentials as far as representing the United States of America in the Olympics, in the Pan American Games, in the World Games, walking away with the gold medals.
Look, the man won't leave me alone. What's wrong with the man?
He's obviously obsessed.
Well, then he should be.
And he'll continue to be obsessed until he does a real number on you and every member of your family.
A real number?
Undoubtedly, you've turned loose.
What do you call this? What do you call this?
I don't know. It could be gold bricking for all I know.
Oh, you mean I'm not really hurt? I'm just trying to get sympathy? You think this? I'm using this as a way for people not to put their hands on me?
Yes, keep going. You're burying yourself deeper and deeper.
Why don't you let me do my job here as host of the show?
Go ahead. Renslow on the receiving end as Kenny's unloading now with a heavy artillery. He is a man obsessed for sure. Watch this power. Look at him. Oh, just like yesterday's garbage. Flung him halfway across the ring. Suplex. Well executed. Patera looks in probably the best shape I've ever seen him in his entire career. The bear hug. And Renslow doesn't waste any time giving up.
Right there. He had the man holding his trunks. And
what are you talking about?
The man didn't have a chance.
Are you watching the same thing?
I'm watching this monitor. I'm watching this monitor.
Please.
I know exactly
the
what I'm doing. You call that a man?
The Olympian, Ken Patera.
Patera chalking up another one. On the road back here in the World Wrestling Federation, these fans behind him, 150%. They love him. You're speechless, Brain, I know.
Keep him away.
He's right here, yes, Kenny. Let's go back and take a look. Look at the look of determination.
Look at that.
Look at that.
That man is allowed to walk the streets. He's allowed to make a living. That man needs to be incarcerated for life.
Since the president, Mr. Jack Tunney, barred you for life from officiating, boy, has the credibility ever improved here in the World Wrestling Federation of the officials.
Well, in my opinion, since they let Danny Davis go as an official.
Barred for life.
That's right.
That's right.
Well, the officials have gone downhill. They're in the wrong place at the wrong time. They don't know how to call a match correctly, and in my opinion, when they let Danny Davis go, So did the efficiency of the World Wrestling Federation.
Well, now that they are calling you a wrestler, what about some of the caliber of competition?
Well, Tito Santana, George Steele, Coco Beware, whoever. When you face Dangerous Danny Davis, by the way, they're going to learn that as a referee I was great, and as a wrestler I'm even.
From Memphis, Tennessee, weighing 243 pounds, the new Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion, the Honky Tonk Man.
I still can't believe this man is champion. It's been a couple of weeks now. Look at that.
I can believe it. Don't that belt look great with those clothes? I mean, it fits this guy. I think this guy was born to wear a belt.
Not the Intercontinental Championship. I still can't believe it.
Look at the prestige Jimmy Hart has now.
I think there's another announcement.
What's
that? At this time, we have a very special treat for everyone in the World Wrestling Federation. I'm about to introduce an individual who you saw in WrestleMania 1. You saw him in WrestleMania 2. And he is here with us right now, ladies and gentlemen, the one, the only, Mr. T!
Excuse always, and bam, and Stuntmeyer's down for the count.
Hogan Talk, quite impressive this week as we take you now to the update.
Throughout the past few weeks here in the special report, I've been covering the superstar Billy Graham story from his days as the heavyweight champion to, of course, that tragic injury, a hip operation, now rehabilitation. And the superstar says he's determined as ever to come back into the World Wrestling Federation. We don't know about that just yet, but we'll find out in the next coming weeks. Slick, your thoughts. You have to be impressed thus far with the determination of the superstar.
Well, you know, bro, yeah, I'm going to have to admit that the Slickster is quite impressed, because to tell you the truth about it, I didn't think the old dude would even try to make a comeback. I figured his spirits would be broken. But let me tell you something, Blood. You remember one thing, Holmes. In your day, you were one of the greatest. But there's a new sheriff in town now, baby. The new breed, the natural.
That's right, and I'm not taking no prisoners. Billy Graham, you never in your wildest dreams ever look like this. Look at that, 22-inch guns, baby. You never had the arms. You never had the deltoids. You never had the pecs. You never had the mentality of the natural Butch Reed. I'm just a natural man from the tip top of my head to the bottom of my feet. And let me tell you something, Billy Graham. I know you've had surgery. I've seen all this. I've seen you go through your therapy, and now you're trying to go through physical training. But let me tell you something. I don't care about all that. All that's history, you understand? Because now is what's happening, 1987. This is the real deal right here, and everything else is second rate.
Well, Natural, you know, we've been told that the workouts are now in full gear. No more lightweight for the superstar. We're going to have our cameras there this week. Could we invite you to join us next week and take a look at it?
I'd love to go down there and join you so you can compare the old broken down has-been warhorse to the new breed, the new style of man.
Well, for all you people out there who aren't familiar with me, let me introduce myself. I'm Ted DiBiase. I'm the Million Dollar Man. And you know, as I travel around this fair country of ours, I run into a lot of people who aren't happy with the way I spend my money. They say that money is the root of all evil. Well, I'm here to tell you that it's not. Because you see, with enough of this right here, I can buy anything. I can have anything I want. I can buy happiness. I can buy love. And if I want to, I can even buy you. Case in point, my man Virgil. Isn't that right, Virgil?
Yes, sir.
Virgil takes care of all of life's little problems that I don't have time to take care of anymore. And you see, if you've got a problem with me, Ted DiBiase, the Million Dollar Man, or the way that I spend my money, you're just gonna have to take it up with Virgil.
Ow! Virgil, I've cut my finger. I need medical attention. Get me to a doctor right now. Virgil, get me to a doctor. Get me to a doctor.
Yes, sir.
Nurse, I need immediate medical attention. I've hurt my finger and I need to see a doctor now.
Sir, I'm sorry. You've got to have an appointment.
Wait, you don't understand. I'm Ted DiBiase. I'm the Million Dollar Man. I don't need an appointment.
Sir, I've got sick people here waiting to see the doctor. You've got to make an appointment.
Virgil, can I see a doctor now?
No, sir.
Virgil, can I get some attention for this finger now?
Sir, I'm sorry.
Virgil, can I get a Band-Aid for this finger now?
Let me see what I can do, sir.
Yeah. Hey, don't be upset with her. She did the same thing that anybody else in her position would have done. She did the same thing that you would have done. She had her price, just like each and every one of you have your price. Everybody's got a price for the Million Dollar Man.
It's obvious the Weasel's trying to keep his word.
They're going to pay their, give their receipt, too. They're going to pay their dues, I'll tell you that. Oh,
he's in the ring area, accompanied by his manager, Elizabeth, from Sarasota, Florida, weighing 238 pounds, Randy Macho Man Savage.
The Macho Man, Randy Savage, accompanied and led by his manager, the very lovely, beautiful, and talented Elizabeth. Another beautiful rope for the Macho Man. You're looking at about 50 grand worth of rope there over the shoulders of the Macho Man, Randy Savage. You get that feeling, Elizabeth, jealous of him? Jealous of him? What? Well,
see that she always tries to outdress him.
Oh, please.
I have an important announcement at this time. It is indeed my pleasure to introduce a man who has truly made his mark here in the World Wrestling Federation. He first appeared in WrestleMania 1, he returned in WrestleMania 2, and now it is my privilege to introduce to you the one and the only Mr. T.
Oh, surprise appearance! Mr. T. Listen to the ovation for Mr. T. Look at the gold, man. You'd like to have some of that. What is he doing here? I don't know what he's doing here. Maybe we'll find out. I didn't have a clue that he was coming out here. Take a look. He looks in great shape, too. Mr. T, the man who went to the aid of World's Heavyweight Champion Hulk Hogan on a number of occasions. Over there shaking hands. Let's see if he shakes hands with the Macho Man. You're looking at him. I don't think we're going to see a handshake here. Look at Elizabeth. She didn't know what to do.
T better be careful. He'll be in the hot. He'll be in the pawn shop with all that gold.
I wish I could read lips. I'd like to know what the Macho Man said. T looking him right in the kisser. Macho Man
turned his back to him. You show him, Randy, Macho Man.
Elizabeth, a little befuddled, she doesn't know exactly what to do. Now T says, I want to shake hands, or at least turn around T, and acknowledge me.
T, you're out of your element. You better go back to Hollywood.
Guy, all he wanted to do was shake hands, right?
Obviously, he goes to Brutus Beefcake Boutique of Hair Design.
Well, once again, David Studemeyer congratulating Mr. T as he's got a standing ovation here from this capacity crowd here this week on Wrestling Challenge. We got to weigh around 380 with all that gold around him.
Who cuts his hair, Ray Charles?
Looks good to me. Macho Man obviously upset. Look at, he's still got his shades on. Give me a break.
He's a Macho Man.
Wow. Planted that knee right in the kisser. Savage now really doing a number on David Studemeyer.
He's going up with it. The shades on and the headband.
Look at this. The patented flying elbow. Oh, goodbye, Mr. Studemeyer.
Count them. One, two, three. Yeah.
Well, just like the Studebaker became extinct, so did Studemeyer. The Macho Man, Randy Savage, very impressive.
The winner of this bout, Randy Macho Man Savage.
In his favorite position, perched high atop the top turnbuckle. Let's go back and take a look at that patented flying elbow, as only he can do it.
I remember Studemeyer said, it'll take a good man to beat me, but it won't take a long.
Oh, please. Right now, let's go to our colleague, Greg DeGeorge, who has with him everyone's favorite, the
Junkyard. It is great to welcome back the Junkyard Dog to the World Wrestling Federation, and what a triumphant return 2 weeks ago. I mean, you are barking and a-biting.
That's my new motto now. Fighting and a bite. Sometimes you got to go behind the closed walls and get the whole life cleaned up and talk to the good man above. But now I got all, I feel good because I got all the little kids in the ring doing the juke each and every day. You know what I'm talking about?
No.
You don't know what the juke is? That's a dance, man. You got to get with time. The juke. You get your legs down, man. You start moving. Hey, try. Come on.
Not that difficult, is it?
No. You don't rock, man. It's a juke.
This next bout is scheduled for 1 fall. Introducing first, from Seattle, Washington, weighing 249 pounds, Greg the Hammer Valentine. The opponent, weighing in at 239 pounds, Raymond Rougeau.
Raymond Rougeau singles matchup here against Greg the Hammer Valentine. As you can see, being accompanied, Raymond, by Jacques,
as well as the Hammer being seconded, it looks like, by the former Canadian heavyweight champion Dino Bravo. Is there, we had a good look there, a couple of our lovely veterans. Come on, Bravo, give me a break. Going to work, the Hammer immediately on Raymond. Brutus Beefcake, formerly a member of the Dream Team, now ostracized, of course, but he's got things in mind for the members of the new Dream Team.
You know, Bravo, stringy peroxide blonde hair of yours, you know, you sure could use a little trick job, a little style. And Valentine, perhaps I could put my mitts into your slimy, greasy locks.
Brain, did you see the look on the face of Brutai?
Sure, the man's miserable. He's mad because he got canned. He got dumped.
He didn't get dumped. He left.
Johnny V told me they unloaded him because he was the weak link of the team.
Raymond now starting to unload on the Hammer. But for my money, the Hammer loves that. He gets more dangerous. The more you pound on him, the more dangerous he becomes.
You can't pound on him enough. And look, shows you what a veteran, what a skilled athlete. He keeps working on that leg because he's going to go for that.
Going to go for what? Did you swallow your tongue or
no,
what?
No, I had a pain in the side of my neck.
Oh, you still got a pain in your neck. You are a pain in the neck. I got news for you.
And you're a pain for me, too.
Look at this. Oh, I thought he was going for the figure four. Instead, he just grapevined the leg and dropped on it.
As I was saying before, I was so rudely interrupted. He's getting the leg ready for the figure four. Now, go ahead, Monsoon. Okay.
Cheering section on the outside on the part of Jacques as Raymond kicks the Hammer off right face first into the turnbuckle. But that leg is hurt all the way across. Oh, what a chop! Shoots him in, backdrop, yes, nailed him with it. Raymond is upset.
I would be too if I fallen off that Jacques with my brother.
Oh. Ran right into the extended knee of the Hammer, who's now going to the outside. Well, he's not one for these aerial tactics, I'll tell you that. Where's he going? He's in a high-risk move pattern. He got caught in midair. Halfway across the ring goes a Hammer.
Mayday.
Could be the beginning of the end. Over for the cover. One, two. Oh, he's on the way down with three, but the Hammer came out the back door. Pile driver.
Ha ha.
He hung onto the legs though. Turns him up. Hooks. Legs are over. Two count. Up. You got to have the Hammer in more of a compromising situation than that to put him away. Referee almost got ran. Oh, look at that. Dino Bravo scooped the leg from the outside. Did you see that?
I missed it. I was doing something else.
Sure. You always miss it. There's the figure four. Bravo comes in. Jacques comes in. Everybody's in the ring now. Referee calling for the bell. I believe we've had a double disqualification of some kind here. As all four men got wrapped up, it should have been a disqualification on the part of Dino Bravo.
I think the Rooster is going to find out now.
The referee declares this bout no contest.
It is a sincere pleasure and honor to welcome my next guest. You know him as the star of the A-Team, the star, of course, of WrestleMania 1 and WrestleMania 2. And the word is out that the World Wrestling Federation is looking for an official who is an enforcer, an official who wrestlers respect, an official who could perhaps use some brute strength to separate the wrestlers. With that in mind, it's a real pleasure to welcome Mr. T, the one and the only. Nice to meet you.
Yes, sir. It's a pleasure to be here. Always a pleasure being in.
Tell us about the enforcer, Mr. T.
That's right, that's right. They need a man to take care of business. I'm the man, so you can start calling me Mr. E, because I'll get in there, push the wrestlers aside if necessary. If wrestler give me a hard time, I hit him upside the head with this here stick, put him in the full Nelson, or throw him out the ring. I'm the man for the job.
So is this cast in stone now?
That's right, that's right. I'm the man. There's nobody can do the job like me. That's why they called me. I prepared myself. I've been chopping down trees, doing push-ups, sit-ups. You know I'm ready. You seen what I did to Rocky? You seen me in WrestleMania 1 and 2?
Danny Davis, beware! The enforcer is coming back to town.
That's right.
Billy Graham, you never in your wildest dreams ever look like this. Look at that, 22-inch guns, baby. You never had the arms. You never had the deltoids. You never had the pecs. You never had the mentality of the natural Butch Reed. I'm just a natural man from the tip top of my head to the bottom of my feet. And let me tell you something, Billy Graham. I've known you've had surgery. I've seen all this. I've seen you go through your therapy. And now you're trying to go through physical training. But let me tell you something. I don't care about all that. All that's history, you understand? Because now is what's happening, 1987. This is the real deal right here, and everything else is second rate.
Well, Natural, you know, we've been told that the workouts are now in full gear. No more lightweight for the superstar. We're going to have our cameras there this week. Could we invite you to join us next week and take a look at it?
I'd love to go down there and join you so you can compare the old broken down has-been warhorse to the new breed, the new style of man.